it is perfectly visible. Now we are placing the speculum. Now the beauty of Delhita is that you can do this surgery without the speculum also. So both ways is possible, but I find it more comfortable with the speculum. Now again aligning the eye centrally onto the screen, and we are ready to do the first step. Now this PI is a two-piece PI. So the first part goes as a cone onto the machine, and the second is the suction ring. Now with the newer machines, all this suction is automated compared to the older J&J machine where the suction was manual. So we put on the suction ring. Now the most important thing to understand here is that before you put that suction, make sure that your eye is properly cleaned so that there is no overflowing fluid or any mucous secretions present on the cornea. Now put on the ring and start with the suction. So at the moment we have a two-piece PI. Very soon we are going to have a single-piece PI, but I am very comfortable with the two-piece because number one, it gives me good control onto the eye. Number two, the suction is very strong. Number three, the eye is not up-rolling, so you avoid having vertical comas. Now the machine drops perfectly onto the eye, very smooth. Once you reach the mark, then you lock. And once the machine is locked, now you start setting the parameters. So we are doing a 6 mm optical zone correction here. So we align the cyclotorsion axis to the mark that we put on the slit lamp. The centration as of now is manual, but very soon we are going to have automated centration in the machine. And now all the parameters are set and we are ready to fire the laser. So you can see here a 6 mm zone, about 7.6 mm transition and a 3.5 mm opening, and the axes are properly aligned. We start, it is going to take about 17 seconds. The laser is nice and smooth. It forms the ring, goes on to the posterior plane and then forms the entry cut. So this you can see the entry cut being made. Now once this step is over, now we are shifting the patient below the microscope. So we untop, speculum being removed from the eye, and shifting the patient below the microscope now. So now I will be showing you the microscope view of the surgery, and this is an unedited clip, so you can see every step. So patient being shifted now to the second machine, and now this is the microscope view. Opening the side cut. Now understand that this is a biconvex lentilcule. So when you are entering the anterior plane, you have to lift your instrument at an angle. So anterior plane opened, posterior plane opened. Now you go in gently and now see how this technology lifts up to the knee. So there is a reason why it is called SiLK, because the dissection is virtually slipping your instrument through the interface. So anterior plane opened, posterior plane opened. Now the beauty of SiLK is that you have these minor attachments at 3 and 9 o'clock position, which keeps the lenticule always in the center. And now just go inside, hold and just pull it. So for beginners, of course, for the first 100 to 200 cases, it is a good idea that you check your lenticule. Post that, once you are confident about the technology, I only check when I find some resistance in the dissection. Now, cleaning the interface so that there are no residual secretions inside. Ironing, this is the most important step so that there are no Bowman folds. And then soft iron with a medicine sponge. And that's it, our procedure is complete. So again, what I want to emphasize here is that the beauty is in the dissection, because we understand that it's a 1 micron spot and ridgeless gap. So the dissection is so smooth and the corneal trauma is...
Can we have Dr. Rahil's view here?
Go ahead, go ahead.
Yeah, so basically what I wanted to highlight was that the beauty of the technology is that they further refine the laser. And now the spot size has been reduced. The bridge is reduced. Now it is bridge-less spots. So that all contributes to the ease of dissection and post-op higher chances of getting that 6-6 power factor next day.
Yeah, we could see that the way smoothly you could, you know, dissect the lenticule, and it came out very nicely. So it was a very nice demonstration. And you have explained each and everything very nicely, and you have taken care of every aspect of what all should be told while demonstrating. So that was a wonderful demonstration, I must say that. Any question from anyone? Any of the audience? So, thanks a lot, Rahil. Dr. wants to ask something.
In the meantime,
good morning, Rahil.
Please be ready.
Hello, sir. Yeah, wonderful demonstration. Okay, in case the suction breaks in between, like you have done 40% of the thing and then at that stage it breaks, then how do you proceed further?
So then we have two options to proceed. Either we can go ahead with the PRP surgery, or we can go ahead with an ICL procedure. Or if the suction break was in the early steps of the surgery, we can also make a flap and proceed like a regular AC procedure.